first step towards getting somewhere is to decide that you are not going to stay where you are. A very warm good morning to one and all present over here. Today, our class 11C has got the golden opportunity to conduct today's morning assembly on the topic Uttarakhand Foundation Day. So, Kanan is here to tell you some amazing facts about Uttarakhand.
Good morning, everyone. Today, I, Kanan Jilana of class 11 Commerce, is here to tell you about some amazing and fascinating facts about Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand is the only state to have Sanskrit as its second official language after Hindi. Uttarakhand is also known as Devbhoomi because of the various religious sites of Hindus are situated over here, like Kedarnath, Gangotri, Yamunotri, Haridwar, Rishikesh, etc. The famous Chipko movement of 1970s took place in Uttarakhand. Tungnath, the highest Shiv temple of the world, is situated in Uttarakhand. Last but not the least, a Bhagwal festival is celebrated in Uttarakhand, in which devotees pelt stones at each other as a part of their rituals.
Uttarakhand was formed as an independent state on 9 November 2000 with Mr. Surjit Singh Barnala as its first governor and Mr. Nityanand Swami as its first chief minister. Behind the foundation of the beautiful state Uttarakhand, there is a great flashback story which everybody needs to know. So let's begin with it. Following the independence of India, the Himalayan districts of erstwhile United Provinces began to receive significant importance in the field of regional literature. In the year 1949, the princely state of Tiri Gadwal acceded to the Union of India. With the adoption of Constitution of India in the year 1950, the state of United Provinces was renamed as Uttar Pradesh and became a state of
the decades of independence, the government of Uttar Pradesh could not meet the expectation to address the interests of the people in the Himalayan region. Unemployment, poverty, lack of educated infrastructure, general underdevelopment, and migration of native people from the hills in search of better opportunity ultimately led to the popular demand for the creation of a separate hill state.
Following the formation of Uttarakhand Kranti Dal for the purpose of achieving statehood, protests gathered momentum and took a form of widespread statehood movements. These protests took a violent turn on 2nd October when Uttar Pradesh police opened fire on a crowd of demonstrators, killing a number of people.
The statehood activists continued their agitation for the next several years, and consequently, the state of Uttarakhand was formed as Uttaranchal on 9 November 2000 by the Uttar Pradesh Reorganization Act 2000. Bifurcating the erstwhile state of Uttar Pradesh on 1st January 2007, Uttaranchal was renamed as Uttarakhand, reclaiming the name by which the region had been known prior to statehood.
Green grass, wind blows, high mountains, curvy roads, pleasant weather, sometimes it's rain, sometimes it's sunny with the dry rains.
Here the mountain is clear, in the morning it's like a silver stair. The sun rays hit the snow, giving a beautiful view and making us glow. Organic farming, organic people with a charming smile, it's like a natural sweetener.
Chardham is alluring pilgrimage. The tigers of Corbett have their own pilgrimage. Travel here whenever you get time. To keep dizziness away, take some time.
termed as Uttarakhand, meaning northern region, which was the traditional name for the area. From then till now, Uttarakhand is proving itself in every field. So, we must feel proud to be an Uttarakhandi and should respect our state. So, here we come to the end of our assembly. I hope that you found the assembly interesting and informative. With this note, we wish you all a very happy Uttarakhand Foundation Day. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.